So hello, team New Horizons family. JuJuan Buford, broadcast from the Detroit metropolitan area. Definitely excited to be posting a brief recap of the Sunday Momentum Call that transpired this past the 12th of November. And this broadcast is going to be brief but comprehensive, so I want to make sure everyone, hey, if you haven't done so, grab a pen, prepare to take notes. We're going to move pretty fast. A lot of content we need to cover. And I thought it was necessary to do this. This is an important topic, right? Because look, as new associates, we're oftentimes bombarded. And I remember vividly being bombarded when I first joined. You know, you had information coming from your sponsor who, that's their responsibility, right? To make sure they equip you with the tools necessary to grow your business. You have your leadership, corporate, emails, invitations to conference calls. Ideally, you're being invited to, you know, maybe perhaps a Facebook group page where you can kind of network and interact more so with those individuals who are working within your organization, right? Build camaraderie and kind of build off each other, right? Feed off each other and celebrate the success stories amongst the group. So you're introduced to a lot in a very short amount of time. Of course, you have a game plan interview that needs to transpire, a private business reception needs to be scheduled, a private conference call, right? You're coming into new business, all these different verbiage and words you may not have been exposed to before are thrown at you oftentimes, right? It just is what it is. We get it. It's part of the deal oftentimes, right? And it's easy to forget that at the end of the day, successful LegalShield associates only really do a couple things pretty consistently and pretty well, right? And it doesn't mean you have to be excellent. It doesn't mean you have to be perfect. We know there's no such thing anyway, because you can always better your best. But there's a couple tasks that successful LegalShield associates focus on. And look, here's the thing too. Seasoned associates, no different, right? There's special projects taking place, other events that may transpire in your marketplace or outside your marketplace you have an interest in. It's easy to get caught up, right? Introduction about different bonuses and incentives can take you a million different directions in terms of how you want to build your business. And so whether it be B2B, networking, there are things that are good for you, but can also be distracting, right? If we lose perspective at the end of the day of what's required to be successful. So, you know, what's the modus operandi, right? What's the job description of a successful LegalShield associate, right? Someone who's building an organization that is growing across North America. Well, here's the thing. The first thing that as associates, the first skill that you have to learn is how to invite and expose, right? How to invite people to learn more about your LegalShield business, whether it be the membership, whether it be the opportunity. We know we lead the membership, we invite to the opportunity. But how do you, what does that mean? Well, that basically means just like in any business endeavor, right? Where you're selling used toothpicks, cars, clothes, shoes, whatever the case may be, you have to ultimately invite individuals to learn more about what it is you're doing or you're out of business, right? And so an invitation is simply utilizing a tool, whether it be a magazine, whether it be a video overview, right? A corporate call or conference call. It can be a DVD. I may have said magazine already. It can be a magazine. It can be a particular video or MP3 or MP4 that was introduced. Just making sure that you're actually utilizing a tool, right? So you invite individuals to look at tools. And when you are able to acquire the commitment to look at the tool, we refer to that as an exposure, right? So you may call up a friend. And you may say, look, you know, we've known each other for quite some time. And look, you're very sharp. You've always been a very hardworking, earnest individual with good business acumen. And look, I just made a decision to get involved with something. I'm really excited about it. If I were to forward some information to you, would you take a look at it? Okay. How soon could you take a look at it, right? If I were to forward you a corporate overview, how soon could you get around to taking a look at it? Okay, so today's Monday, so you can look at it, you'll see it by Tuesday at 12. So if I were to give you a call at Tuesday, perhaps maybe 1 o'clock, you've seen it by then? You sure? I mean, yeah, you've seen it? Okay, great, fantastic. Look, I so appreciate it. I look forward to hearing your feedback. I'll give you a call tomorrow at 1 o'clock to hear your feedback. Okay, fantastic, great, thanks, right? So you acquire the commitment. Now, here's the thing, because there's a skill that we oftentimes don't talk about enough, right? And we talk about the invitation exposure process, and that's edification, right? So if I'm sharing some information, let's say it's a DVD, Let's say it's with a coworker or a colleague. And, you know, I may approach the coworker and colleague and say, look, you know, I think I found something that I'm really excited about, that I really think is going to help change the future of my family, the projection financially in the direction we're headed. And look, you know, before I make a final decision, I'd really appreciate your feedback. You're someone that I've worked with. You know, I want you to evaluate it and tell me whether or not you think it's a good, smart idea, right? So, look, there's this DVD. There's a gentleman on here. Oh, man, his story's absolutely incredible. He's actually a former post office worker, locked arms with the leadership here at this company. And his story really inspired me. In respect, he had a supervisor, a boss. You know how it is, right? Got upset with him for some petty reason, cut his hours so he wasn't able to take care of his household, take care of his family. And, you know, this gentleman didn't sit back on his laurels, right? He didn't wait for a government handout or someone or some magical fall in his lap. He learned about our company, plugged into the proven system, and upon doing so, and a couple short months, he was able to earn enough income to walk off the post office job. Really love his story. I mean, not exactly, you know, it wasn't like he was a PhD or a immensely successful business owner beforehand. That's what kind of attracted me to this. And look, you know, today, the gentleman earns approximately $500,000 a year, over $500,000 a year. And so I'm really excited about this. And look, it may not be for you, but if you could take a look at it, let me know what your feedback is. Oh, man, I'd be so appreciative. Right, edification, right? You're not going to approach someone and invite them to look at a video or a magazine and say, hey, you should look at this magazine. It's got a great service, a great product. You know, the company's doing really well. You know, if you take a look at this magazine, take a look, you got to give people a reason why. You have to remember, at the end of the day, people will evaluate or investigate or take a look at something for their own reasons. And so edification is important, right? So that's a skill, though, right? Because it's not like we walk around edifying tools all day long or edifying individuals. That typically doesn't happen in a workplace, right? I know certainly when I was working in corporate America, no one walked up to me on a random and said, hey, Mr. Buford, hey, JuJuan, you are absolutely incredible. You're fantastic. You're such a tremendous success story. You know, I wish I could tell other people. I'd love the opportunity to introduce you to some other individuals whom I know, love, and trust, where they could see you as an example of, you know, how far they can progress in life, right? That never happened. Even the individuals who were tremendously successful in the corporate environment I worked in, that didn't happen, right? So education is a skill. So the number one responsibility, right, the number one task or job description is to learn how to invite and expose. And, of course, I could dedicate another 5, 10, 20 minutes because it deserves it. We just don't have the time now. So, but understand that that's the number one thing, like that's first, right? How do you invite, how to expose, right? And definitely afterwards, after you've listened to this, feel free to call your leadership, give me a phone call, email, text, whatever the case may be, and we can elaborate further on it, all right? So you've invited and you've exposed, right? You learn how to make invitation exposures. That's the first skill, right? That's the first key performance indicator that you have to know how to do to have success here in LegalShield. Now, what's the second thing? Well, how do you convert an exposure to a guest, right? So we invite, we expose individuals to learn about our business, and then we invite them again to actually learn 100% of the information, right? A guest is someone who's attended a briefing, perhaps participated on a recruiting call or corporate overview. Maybe they've watched a DVD in its entirety. Maybe they watched a private business reception video in its entirety, right? So as opposed to a 5-10 minute clip, or as opposed to a 5-10 minute recording, or perhaps as opposed to looking through a magazine and flipping through the pages, right, kind of perusing it a little bit, now we invite them to an event because we know the bigger the event, the bigger the decision, right? And so that's the next skill, right, to actually set an appointment, convert an exposure to a guest, right? Someone who, instead of just seeing a little bit, they've got a taste, they have an interest in learning more, and now we show them, we give them the full entree, right? They had a small plate, now we're moving them to the entree. And that's a skill as well, right? So I may follow up with Demetrius, whom I've shared a DVD with or a corporate overview. And I may say, look, Demetrius, look, I call him up Tuesday, 5 o'clock, Tuesday, 1 o'clock. Demetrius, JuJuan, do you have a moment? Okay, great. Look, talk to me. What did you like best, right? It's assumptive. I don't call it. Did you take a look at that video? I'm calling because I just want to make sure you had a chance. No, it's assumptive. Hey, you said you'd take a look at it at 1 o'clock, right? So yeah, what'd you like best? Well, Demetrius may say, well, I like the membership. Great, I like the membership too. He may say, I like the opportunity to earn income. I may say, look, I like that too. He may say, look, I like Jason Lavender's gray jacket. It was incredible. I may say, yeah, I like his gray jacket. It's incredible too. I'm sure it's contributing somehow to the fact he's one of the top income earners in the company. So I like his gray jacket too. I mean, it's affirmation, right? Whatever the person says they like best, you just simply affirm it. Now, are there going to be individuals who look at the information and say, look, it's not for me. I'm not interested. Don't ever call me again. I think this sucks. You suck. On rare occasions, that's going to happen. Look, people can be rude. They can be obnoxious. I just want you to anticipate that, right? Here's the thing, they did you a favor, right? As opposed to you spending days, weeks, months pontificating as to why they joined or didn't join and why they're dragging their feet, they let you know right out the gate. So, you know, count it as a blessing, if you will. You'll understand that later. So here's the thing. They say, I like the membership or I like the opportunity. You may respond, that's great. That's fine. I did too. Look, let me ask you a question. On a scale of 1 through 10, 1 being you just have an interest in the membership, 10 being not only interested in the membership, but you're also interested in the opportunity to earn income for a company. Like, where do you fall? And it may say a 3, a 4, a 5, a 6, or a 7. Look, typically the response is still the same. That's fantastic. That's great. Look, let me do you a favor. Because you're a sharp, smart person. And I know sharp, smart individuals typically don't make a decision based on a video or just a brief recording or a telephone conversation, right? You know, typically, when's the best time to catch up with you for 15 or 20 minutes? Like, what works best for you, morning or afternoon? They may say, well, the morning works best. Okay, so 9, 10, or 11. They may say, well, the evening works best. Okay, 3, 5, 7, what works best for you? They may say, well, 5 o'clock, great. Well, look, how about we do this? I'll catch up with you for about 20, 30 minutes. We'll sit down. I'll share 100% information. That way you can make an educated decision. That's called a sit down, right? You invited them to an appointment. That's a sit down. That's what we refer to it as typically, a sit down, right? So you're inviting them to a sit down so you can do what? Share 100% of it. Maybe share the entire PBR video. Maybe pull out one of the PDF forms. We used to refer to it as a flip chart. Now we have these easy cards, right? But regardless, you just want to give them an opportunity to see 100% information. Ideally, it's a 2-on-1, right? You have your leadership with you to help share the information. But the bottom line is you're utilizing a tool. So if you're talking to the person one-on-one, you're utilizing some type of tool, just like when you expose them, right? Because we know, look, here's the bottom line. 98% of individuals don't want to feel like salespersons. They have a negative stigma attached with salesmanship, and they're not going to feel comfortable having a conversation that a salesperson might have the skill set to have. And so it doesn't duplicate, right? Individuals have a fear of talking in front of individuals, right? So utilizing tools, whether you're scheduling sit-downs or whether you're doing exposure, is so absolutely important because everything that works doesn't duplicate, but we want to do things that duplicate. The things that duplicate work, right? It builds long-term. So, yeah, we rely heavily on tools and events, right? That's like a principle in our organization, tools and events. So that's part of the process. You learn how to invite someone to an appointment. If you invite them to a luncheon, that's an appointment at a luncheon. If you invite them to a briefing, that's an appointment at a briefing. You invite them to a corporate regional, or we may refer to the Super Saturday, depending on the market that you're in, the convention, right? Once again, the bigger the event, the bigger the decision, but that's an appointment, that's a guest now, right? And if you invite to the briefing, now they have a third party, right? That speaker in front of the room kind of serves as a tool, if you will, to share the information, third party, with your prospect. And so they get a chance to see 100% information. So that's the second skill, right? And it's powerful. This is what you really want to focus on, taking from someone from exposure to invite them to an appointment where they can get 100% information and really make an educated decision. And we know live events, opportunity for interaction, belief, social evidence, it's all there, right? So there's a stronger likelihood that the individual will take advantage of the membership, and it's a stronger likelihood that they may join you in business. So definitely learning this skill, right? Skill number two, converting someone from invitation, exposure, to a guest. And so how does the invitation sound? It may sound a little bit like this. Look, what is your schedule looking like Tuesday at 6? You're free? Okay, fantastic. Look, there is a business networking mix and mingle. There's an app launch workshop. There's a business launch workshop taking place. Look, don't invite individuals to meetings. You know, I try to avoid opportunities at all costs because it sounds so cliche. And look, here's the bottom line, particularly professionals. We're meeting out. No one wants to go to another meeting. But I can invite someone to say, look, this upcoming Tuesday, there's going to be a gathering of professionals, entrepreneurs, individuals who have tremendous success. I mean, some of these individuals are having $500 a day. Some of them are having $5,000 a day. So the bottom line, they've earned a lot of money, helped a lot of people, really down to earth. You owe it to yourself. Look, because I know you want to get 100% information, right? Look, you owe it to yourself to attend. You can sit down, ask questions, get 100% information, and make an educated decision. Look, if I were to extend this invitation to you to attend this event, to attend this mix and mingle, to attend this business workshop, you know, I have a lot of respect for these individuals. So, you know, definitely you want to come with your A game. Look, you know, can I count on you to attend? If I were to send an invitation, would you attend? Would you come out with me, right? Would you attend this event with me? Absolutely. Okay, fantastic, incredible, right? Once again, that's where the edification comes into play. No one's interested in attending just another meeting or another appointment, if you will. People attend events like that because they are coming ultimately at the end of the day for the people. People, you know, won't go to a meeting to save their lives, but they'll travel miles to see somebody burn, right? In other words, what I mean, right? You know, part of the reason why the Million Man March and part of the reason why the march that Martin Luther King led, trust me, a lot of people came with nothing else just for the experience. So which promoting at the end of the day is experience. And once again, another 5-10 minutes, easy, I could go just focus on this topic alone. But I want to make sure we understand that that's part of the job description. Number one, inviting exposures, and then converting those exposures to a guest. And look, three-way calls, absolutely imperative, right? Three-way calls, in my mind, that's like three exposures in one. That can be almost considered like a mini event where you literally, you know, someone, you're in the middle of inviting them to an event, and whether it be a sit down or a briefing, and they may say, well, look, I have additional questions, I'm not ready to commit. You know, look, I understand. I know exactly how you feel. Look, there's a gentleman, there's a young lady, there's a lady whom I respect, has had tremendous success, earned a lot of money, been really down to earth. They've been a tremendous blessing to me, just an incredible mentor. Look, let me do you a favor. Let me do you a favor. Once again, let me do you a favor and give you an opportunity. Look, I just want to make sure you get all your questions. Let me do you a favor. I'm going to make sure we have a brief introduction. Hold on one moment, right? Look, you're not asking for permission for a three-way call. You're letting them know, look, this three-way call is going to transpire. Let me do you a favor, right? And so you edify that individual. And that leader, that individual that understands how to conduct a three-way call, they're going to turn around and they're going to edify you. But more importantly, they're going to share a story. They're going to share additional information to help that individual whom you are inviting to learn about your business come to a point of decision as to whether or not they want to learn more, or quite possibly the three-way call may be enough for an individual to say, you know what, I've heard enough, right? I've heard the story. I understand how the membership works. And look, I want to participate. Now, how do I get started, right? And of course, you look to sit down, or that three-way expert may invite them to an event. Because at the end of the day, that's where this all leads to, an event where someone can really make an educated decision. So